So after watching the implosion, you decide to dive in yourself. So what drew you to then go work in a dot-com?
Yeah, so when I was at Piper, I was, you know, again, covering these companies. And so one of the great things was I had access to the senior management of these companies. I got to sit in a room across the table with Jeff Bezos. I got to do the same with Meg Whitman, who was running eBay and now runs HP. And I got to sit, before Google was even a household name by any means, and far long before they were public, I got to sit in Sergey Brin's office and talk to them about you know, their aspirations to go public and for us to be a part of that. So I had sort of an interesting perch being able to see all of this happening. And when the dot-coms imploded, the equity research business covering internet imploded almost just as much, if not more. And they were laying people off, and I was a survivor in those layoffs. But again, the environment had really changed. The opportunity had closed down substantially. And so I looked to pivot again, and I went to go work for a company called Overture, which was under my coverage as an analyst. And it was kind of the right size. It hadn't already sort of hit those Yahoo levels where it was going to be huge. It was about 500 or 600 employees. It was about $1.5 billion market cap, and they were the inventors of paid search listings. So you know, when you search, probably everyone searches on Google today, when at the time it was different, but when you search on Google and you see the advertisers' listings, those are all the matching technology and everything that goes behind that was what Overture really invented, and they were powering, they had 100% market share across Yahoo and Alta Vista and all the different search engines that were out there at the time. And that was like gold to advertisers. It was really the first business model on the internet that worked, you know, where they were all like, well, we're going to build, we're going to get tons of eyeballs, and then we're going to figure out how to make money. And they didn't, and they all, you know, got hammered for it. But the one that survived was search. And so I went towards that strength to be in the search space and be part of that. And even though there are many other business models that work now on the internet, the revenue for Google does a million things, but you know, I don't know what the number is, 90% of their revenue still comes from search. So all that money and, you know, that is flowing in through that, that's what they're using to build Android and maps and, you know, float balloons doing internet over Africa, and everything else they're doing is all flowing in through that paid search business.